June 13 is when I bought the flat, and as part of the agreement I was said that we are going to get a premium view with a cricket ground and a cricket stadium there. And after the cricket stadium, there was supposed to be the clubhouse, and after the clubhouse, the river view. So from my flat, I was supposed to have an uninterrupted view of close to 700 to kilometer, 700 meters to a kilometer. And later on, after collecting 98% of the payment from me, they sent me a note stating that there is a slight change in the plan. Instead of the cricket stadium, they are going to have a school ground which is going to be coming over there. And since the school ground is also of the same specification as the cricket stadium, it is as good as what they tried to convince. I had a long, lengthy conversation with them stating that you are trying to push me to a good which is not as per the specification which I bought, and I would want to have the refund. However, they continued to convince me that it still happens to meet the same set of specification. Then later on in 2016, when they asked 2017, when they asked me to come for the possession of the house, I asked them to do a site visit, to which they denied. So I came on my own to meet a couple of friends of mine who live in the societies nearby in Oceania and so on. Only to figure out that there is a sewage treatment plant created right in front of the place where the cricket stadium was supposed to be. And in fact, if you would pan onto the view of the building over here, you would see that most of the houses, they have their slidings and all windows closed. And all of that is because of the noise and the bad smell that one gets. You can see, you know, clothes hanging out over there. So it clearly shows you that these are occupied flats. But, you know, they are all their sliding windows are closed only because of the stench and the smell out over there. So I have denied taking the possession of the flat that I have bought from Lodha.
You refused to take the possession.
I have refused to take the possession, and I have requested Lodha to refund my money in full along with the borrowing charges that I have incurred upon, and let me get out of the deal. And Lodha is still using all their muscle in to force me and continue with the engagement and take the possession of the flat. So that's where the situation is. However, it's not a great place that one would like to be, given that the stench and the noise that you have over here.
Yeah, I would just like to recap from my earlier conversation with you. Until 98% of your payment had been done, you weren't even informed of any change in their plans.
That's correct. Up to my agreement was done on May 22nd of 2013. The agreement was done post they took 20% of payment from me. So from May 22nd 2013 till December 2013, they took away 98% of the payment. And in February 2014 is for the first time they informed me that there is a change in the plan. And in that plan also, there is no sewage treatment planned. I still have an unobstructed view all the way till the river from my flat as part of that plan. Only to discover all of that as a lie later on back in 2017.
And even then they refused to give you a refund.
Yes, they acknowledge that the flat is not as per the specification what I asked for, but continue to maintain that they are not going to refund my money, though the flat is not as per the specification which I bought.
They offered to refund it to you in 24 installments, but without the interest, is it?
At some point in 2017, they said that they would make some standard deductions and then offer me the refund of my money, and I asked them what those standard deductions would be, to which they said that I'll have to come and sign some papers agreeing to the standard deduction, and then they would disclose me the standard deduction charges. I chose not to go that route because I was unsure. They could have, you know, got the paper signed and told me that, you know, standard deduction is equal to 100%. So I didn't go for that option.
Right. So basically, they just wanted you to sign blind, a deal.
Yes.
And it was very clear they are not giving you 100%. They are not even giving you with interest, but they are not even going to give you 100% or so it seemed.
Yes.
Whatever their standard deductions were, they did not want to be transparent about it. And they wanted you to sign on the dotted line, which you refused to do.
Yes, I was forced to sign blind for the first time when I bought the flat. at the time of agreement. I have that documented as well from them. So this time I was overcautious. I said that I am not signing any deal till the time I read it.
And even after 98%, they did not want you to see your own house, right? They wanted you to sign a possession, which would be what? Some kind of a disclaimer or a waiver of rights.
They for getting the possession, they want me to pay the remaining 2% of the payment which is there, and sign certain set of agreements before them, before they give me the possession of the house or even take me to my house to have a look at it.
Even show you your house, even allow you to permit to see your house and see where it is and see how it faces.
Correct.
So you had to learn how it is by coming over here to some other friends in Olympia?
Oceana.
So, Oceana.
So I have quite a few friends who stay in Casa Rio, in Casa Bella. We work for the same organization. So I found my way around. I came to the Persiana building. I figured out which wing is B, C. Met a lot of residents out over here. Discussed my issues with them and then figured out which one is my flat. And then I was fairly disappointed to figure out.